Creating a random block quiz using the Canvas LMS is fairly simple, and in this tutorial I'll walk you through all the steps. All you really need to get started is a Canvas course populated with question pools, or a test bank. How do you get question pools into your Canvas course? You can always build them yourself, or if you're currently using a WW Norton textbook, you can install a free course pack if you're a qualified instructor. It only takes a few minutes to install the course pack, and it won't cost your students or you anything. If you're interested in learning more, go to www.norton.com/coursepacks. So, to get started building the random block assessment, you'll first want to log into your Canvas course. Once you log in, select Quizzes from the left-hand navigation screen. Now, you'll want to make sure that you actually have some test banks to draw on, and to do that, you'll click Manage Question Banks from the upper right-hand corner of your browser. If you're using a free Norton course pack, you'll see a list of question banks you can draw from already, and you can use those to create your random block assessment. If you don't, you could always use your own personal bank of questions. Since I now know that I have about 300 questions from chapters 1 through 3 to work with for this particular example, I'll click the back button and then I'll select create a new quiz from the upper right-hand corner of the screen. From this screen, you can first change your quiz deployment settings to anything you'd like. So for example, I can choose to allow students to take my quiz twice, though because I'm creating a random block assessment, they'll see a new quiz with different questions that second time around. Actually, that might be something that you're looking for. So once I've adjusted my settings, I'm ready to select the question tabs. And from there, I'll click the New Question Group button. It's into this group that we're going to place all of the potential questions that we're interested in from chapters 1 to 3. I'll title this group Chapter 1 through 3 Quiz Random Block, though you can name it anything you want. And then I'll instruct Canvas to choose 30 questions at random from the 300 question potential that we have in this random block group. Now that I've created my group, I need to add some questions, so I'll click Find Questions. I want to add all of the questions that are available in the Chapter 1 test bank, so I'll click Select All. Next, I'll scroll down and then choose Chapter 1 through 3 Random Block from the drop-down menu, and then I'll click Add Questions. Canvas will now add all 101 of the Chapter 1 questions to my Random Block group. And now I'm going to repeat the process for Chapter 2. And then for Chapter 3. When I'm satisfied with the questions I've chosen, I'll select Save, and notice that you can unselect questions if you don't want to include it. Once again, I'll have an opportunity to change the deployment settings by clicking the Edit button. If I'm satisfied with my quiz as it is, all I need to do now is deploy it. To deploy your random block quiz in Canvas, first select Modules and scroll to the area into which you've decided to release your quiz. For my purposes, I'm going to place it at the end of the Chapter 3 module in the WW Norton course pack. Next, you want to select the gear icon from the block into which you want to release the quiz, and you're going to find that in the upper right-hand corner. When you select that, you'll choose Add Content. On the next screen, from the drop-down list, choose Quiz, because that's what we want to add, the new quiz that we just created a moment ago. And then I'll scroll down until I find the assessment I've just created. I'll select on it, and then so I can easily find it later, I'll indent it 3 levels over. At this point, you can easily move the assignment anywhere you like, just by dragging up or dragging down. Now, if you want to make sure that the questions are being randomly drawn, you can test this by simply clicking on the quiz and then selecting the Take the Quiz button. Then scroll all the way down to the bottom and click Submit Quiz. Now, when I take the quiz again, you'll notice that the first question here is different from the first question in the first quiz. So this is a completely different quiz. And if I repeat the process, still another set of questions. So this is working properly. Each time I create a quiz, I'm getting a different group of questions. And that's all there is to it. If you'd like to learn more about our Open Course Pack initiative, like the one you just saw in this tutorial, go to www.norton.com/coursepacks.